Everyone, real quick before we get started, I did record all of the outtakes in one take, so I don't really have an intro for every single video, so I'm just recording this really quick to put at the beginning of every video. But yeah, I hope you guys have been enjoying so far. If you have, be sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe. Also, check out the links in the description, and let's get into it.
I wonder if these are problems he has faced in his relationship. Okay, I'm not falling for the fake card, dude, like I did on the ad.
Fuck!
I used to perform comedy on a stage.
Suggested stay inside
in front of people.
That is an interesting way to utilize the card feature. He didn't actually use it, but it's kind of a funny way to, because normally cards say like suggested and then like a playlist or a video, but it says suggested stay inside.
Fuck.
I used to perform comedy on a stage in front of people, living humans. And I would try to be funny, and then the audience would sometimes laugh. And that was really helpful because I would hear their laughter, and that would let me know that what I was doing was funny to them, as opposed to
you don't
now
get that inside,
where I'll try to be funny,
trying to be
like
stuck in.
Oh, and then
I laughed, Bo. I laughed.
You see what I'm saying?
Beyonce is my spirit animal. That's you know what? Was that in the final cut, that particular mug? Because that kind of like a white woman saying, you know, Beyonce is my spirit animal. Like, I don't know, like if it's trying to be an ally or what, but it's kind of, you guys know what I'm saying? What did he say? Pine cone and the oatmeal. Nice. Hearing it without the music is just funny. The faces. Hi. I will say, white woman's Instagram probably has some of my favorite shots. And probably some of the most effort put into them.
So cool. My God, what a cool thing to do. Make this fucking stupid.
What is up? Welcome back to another episode of the podcast. I am your host, Bo Burnham, joined in studio, as always, by my co-host, Bo Burnham.
What up, what up, what up?
And we are two comedians who are talking shit, no filter, not giving a fuck what anybody thinks.
Not a fuck.
And, yeah, not apologizing for it.
Apologizing, so,
let's get into
yeah.
it. Might say some crazy shit.
Yeah, let's do it.
PC culture, man. It's
fucking exhausting,
right,
bro.
It's fucking out of control.
Exhausting.
It's just... our culture has been taken over by a radical group of SJW feminist freaks.
Feminist,
who hate comedians.
Yes. They hate us.
Who are anti-comedy and anti-joke.
Totally.
And it's gotten to the point where you can't say anything.
No,
literally.
100%.
You cannot say anything.
Literally.
I will try to say something right now.
Yeah.
Watch. Yeah, and he is trying.
And
it's unbelievable because we have fallen so far from the heyday of comedy.
So depressing, dude.
When, you know, Tony the Pancake was headlining the comedy
or
store.
Or Salami Williams.
On a Tuesday night.
Oh,
they would
crush.
They just fucking
just
murder.
Destroying.
Just fucking
absolute.
Just making the
just crushing, dude.
You know? And it sucks because these people, they don't understand comedy.
Of course not.
We're joking.
It is not
They're
that
jokes.
Serious, guys.
Okay.
It's not that
joking
serious.
Around.
And also,
all right? We as comedians are philosophers.
Yes,
all right,
dude.
Lenny Bruce, Richard Pryor,
we
are
stuff,
we hold
up
a mirror, history-changing cultural figures, and you need to recognize that. All right, comedy is an art form.
Yeah, of course right? It is. We're artists.
It's an art form. And, and it's important because it's one of the only art forms that is not
gay.
No. Or, well, no. We can't say that. But, but yeah, gay. But not... Now they're going to come after us, right? We're going to get canceled for saying this.
You homophobes.
We're not being homophobic when we say that.
It's gay is just
if there was another
gay.
Word that meant gay that wasn't gay, we'd use that.
We would.
But there isn't one.
But there isn't.
So
it's gay.
But yeah, so it's really just a war on comedy that I realized. I was, you know, I was having a conversation with my sparring partner.
Nice.
And I realized that the war on comedy is really...
Come on, Jeffrey, you can do it, pave the way.
That was interesting. I wonder if he was making fun of like Joe Rogan or like some podcasts like that. Super like controversial and like that. I was kind of that's the kind of vibe I was getting. Of course, you have the one guy who's like leading it, and the other guy who's just kind of like, for lack of a better word, just like a puppet. Like literally just agreeing with everything, repeating everything that you're saying, but also claims to like, you know, have all the same beliefs and everything that you're saying. And they talk about how like they don't give a fuck and they're gonna say whatever they want, and like PC culture is just like, you know, gay or whatever. And but as soon as they say that, they start backing up like, oh well, no, we didn't mean that, and like, oh, now we're gonna get canceled and blah blah. But they like backtrack a little bit, so they talk about how they don't give a fuck at the beginning, but then as soon as they feel like they may have said something that like could have consequences or repercussions on like their brand or their image or whatever, they backtrack and like try to like spin it in a different light. It's interesting. And then of course you have the Man Stuff Dick Spray, which is like catering to all of these, like, I don't know, to me it's always like it's those type of products are like catered toward like the masculine type, but it's always like it seems like the people who are like unsure of like their masculinity, or like, you know, it's like the dudes with the big trucks that don't have like a muffler on, you know, that like the joke is like small dick energy or something like that. It's like it seems like those are the guys who are like buying that kind of stuff, but they're like doing it to like compensate. I don't know. Anyway, Bezos won
on comedy is really...
Come on, Jeffrey, you can do it, pave the way, put your back into it, tell us why, show us how, look at where you came from, look at you now, Zuckerberg and Gates and Buffett, amateurs can fucking suck it, fuck their wives, drink their blood, come on, Jeff, get him!
I'm so glad we get this behind the scenes. You can kind of hear it through the earphones. Oh, I love it. So happy we got Bezos one behind the scenes.
Different colored back wall. That's good for something. That's good. Now we're fucking talking.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, does he have like fake teeth?
My. Oh.
Well, we got another ad. Are those fake teeth?
I get a lot of questions from young people. They'll say, how can I create content that will cut through the noise? And I tell them, be yourself.
Okay,
because the landscape content is so competitive. There are so many people with so many different skills. The only thing you really have to offer at the end of the day is yourself. So offer yourself by being yourself. And if that doesn't work, then be somebody else, because you may suck. Who you are on a fundamental sort of unchangeable level may just be uninteresting and unwatchable and useless. So if you're that, be somebody else for sure. And then if that doesn't work, then go like this.
Okay. Yep. It reminds me of something that comes to mind is Ninja. I don't know if you guys know Ninja, like big, you know, made his like exploded over Fortnite when Fortnite was big, and he's, you know, a Twitch streamer, and now he's, you know, he's been in movies like Free Guy. He does like so many endorsement and brand deals. And another thing he does is he has this masterclass about how to become a streamer. And one of the things that he said was, I have nothing against Ninja. Like, obviously the dude deserves everything that he has, super hard worker and stuff, but it just seems like he's a little out of touch with like the way that like live streaming and content creation is now. Like, he kind of, he did get lucky, but he also worked super hard, and he does deserve, you know, everything that he had. But like, one of the things that he says in his masterclass about becoming a big streamer or being a good streamer is that like, when you're a small streamer and somebody comes into your chat, like, always have your user list up so you can see when new people come. And he says to immediately call that person out and get them engaged and get them talking and stuff, which for streaming culture and especially Twitch.tv culture, like, that's like a huge no-no, because there's a thing called lurking, to where somebody just wants to go to your stream and they just want to watch. They don't want to say anything because maybe they're anxious or whatever. And if you immediately call them out, that immediately like invalidates, you know, their lurk. Like, they probably will immediately feel anxious and leave. So it's just like, it's somebody who's like super big, who's just a little bit disconnected on like how to grow, even though they're a huge streamer or content creator or something like that. So that's kind of what this whole inside content creation thing reminded me of. It's like, you have this big person, you know, Bo Burnham, the content creator, like obviously very successful content creator. And then he's just like, oh yeah, all you got to do is just be yourself, you know? And if that doesn't work, be somebody else. And then if that doesn't work, make silly faces. And that was all of that was all of his advice. So it's just funny how some huge content creators do have that mindset, right? And I mean, he's not inherently wrong. You should definitely be yourself. Like, I try to be myself as much as possible, or as true to myself as I can with this. But there are people out there who, you know, being themselves, it honestly just might not work for them. For being a content creator and like being able to grow, and honestly, like, the next thing is not necessarily be somebody else, but copy other people. Because if you find something that other people are doing that works, the odds are if you're able to do that as well and do it well, then it'll probably work for you too. But you know, some people might have a problem with that, which, you know, to each their own. I mean, it's kind of what I did with reacting. I watched other people react and I thought to myself, you know, I can do this, but, you know, I try to do it in my own way and better in my eyes, at least. And I don't know, it seems to be kind of going okay so far. So maybe, you know, we're doing it, but yeah, I'm very passionate about content creation and all that stuff. It's part of like what I do as a full-time job. So, I got a lot to say about it, but yeah, it was interesting. Let's go back.
This.
Just make silly faces. It's like a Google. It's like a Google ad too. Do we have another song?
They're really gonna make me vote for Joe Biden. How is the best case scenario, Joe Biden?
Case scenario, Joe. It really does feel like that sometimes, man. Like,